This organization has been at the forefront of caring for animals, rescuing animals for 10 decades now. Literally, millions of animals have seen their way to a better life because of the Houston SPCA. The organization was started in 1924. There were big issues for cats and dogs in the community. Horses were still working in the streets of Houston, and there weren't any laws protecting them. The Houston SPCA was formed to address the critical needs of animals in the community, and at that time, we also were chartered to help women and children in the Depression, helping families to find shelter. As we moved through the decades, we never left behind programs for families, programs for children. You know, you can't have one without the other. Pets are family. Cruelty investigation has been at the very heart of what this organization has provided for our community. In the 1940s, we were very active in rescuing cats, dogs, and horses from cruelty, and that continues to this day.
I feel a great responsibility to serve the community. Some of the cases that we run into are going to be anywhere from abandonment cases, medical cases, all the way to just neglect, you know, failure to provide food, water, and shelter. It's very rewarding to be able to get an animal out of a bad situation. Once we hand them over to our veterinarian team, I know they're in good hands. To me, it feels like they get a second chance at life.
Moving into the 1950s, the organization raised money to build a state-of-the-art animal shelter. In the 1960s, the organization created an ambulance service for injured animals. It was the only one then, and it's the only one now. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. This year alone, our emergency veterinary medical technicians on their ambulances will rescue roughly 4,000 animals.
When those animals come in, our veterinary team of veterinarians and veterinary technicians and veterinary assistants, they just jump right on it, assessing the animal, getting them healthy. Our cruelty investigations team brings in animals that also need urgent care. When there is an urgent situation, there are no questions asked. There is no hesitation. Everyone just bands together to do what's needed to make sure the animals get what they need.
I've been a veterinary nurse here at the shelter for 45 years. Throughout the years, we've seen lots of cases. We see mostly dogs and cats, but we've seen exotic animals, tigers, bears, lions, oh my. I think the one thing that motivates me mostly is that you can make a difference. If you make a difference for just one animal, you've made a difference.
In the 1980s, we really upped our game in terms of our focus on helping animals in natural disasters, not just helping our own community, but helping organizations in other states responding to animal needs in the aftermath of disasters.
Particularly in times of hurricanes and flooding, we welcome the opportunity to be that facility where animals can come and know that they're going to be able to get the care and safety that they need.
In the 1980s, we sought a partnership with local law enforcement to get tougher on animal cruelty cases, to find justice for animals. The Precinct 1 Constable's Office, they actually have officers who office out of our facilities and are serving all of the warrants and making arrests in those cases. In the 1990s, we opened a state-of-the-art animal shelter. It was 40,000 square feet, and we thought we would never fill it up. In the 2000s, we did a lot of work to strengthen the organization's commitment to all animals in the community. We expanded our work for horses. Now we see anywhere from 200 to 600 horses that may come in to our care.
90 to 100% of the animals that come into our care are from cases of cruelty and neglect. So a lot of the things that we see can be very heart-wrenching. When they first come in, they're usually about 200 to 500 pounds underweight. And so they're incredibly malnourished, and they literally have no personality. They're entirely shut down. For us, it's that exciting moment when they do almost give you that little bit of sass and kind of like push back on you a little bit, because you know they're actually healthy enough to be able to express themselves.
There was a dream to build a wildlife hospital. In 2007, we did. The first year, we took in around 3,000 native wild animals. And this year, it will be closer to 13,000, more than 360 species.
Here at the Wildlife Center, we take care of injured and orphan wildlife. We rehabilitate them if they're injured or they're sick. We also do a lot of environmental education. We get all kinds of different wildlife, lots of native wildlife, from little bitty baby hummingbirds all the way up to pelicans. We get a lot of mammals that we take care of. The public really appreciates it because we get so many animals. This time of year in the spring, we'll get over 100 animals a day.
In 2018, the Houston SPCA once again opened a state-of-the-art campus, 8 buildings across 12 acres. If you build it, they will come, and that's exactly what has happened here. We house and care for close to 2,000 animals, sometimes on a daily basis. We have built something for the comfort and care of animals while they're with us. It is a gift to the people of Houston and the entire region. We started a program with Texas A&M University where fourth-year senior veterinary students are trained here on our campus.
Fourth-year veterinary students at Texas A&M are required to spend 2 weeks with us learning how to practice veterinary medicine in a shelter environment. They learn all about emergency medicine, performing surgeries, and cruelty investigations. We want to set an example. We want to be the foundation for the veterinarians and veterinary technicians who are coming after us, and we want them to build on whatever we've done.
With COVID, we stayed fully operational. I am never more proud of this organization than when we step up on those challenges and we meet them.
The pandemic really, in a way, just shone a spotlight on the need for fostering. There was all of a sudden this crisis where we just had to call out, every one of these animals has to get out of here and go to a safe place. And people stepped up and did that.
One of the newest offerings to our community is a wellness clinic for owned animals in order to improve the health of animals across our community, but also provide an affordable option for people.
People are able to bring in their pets to do preventive care. The Wellness Center is a great example of how the Houston SPCA recognizes the needs of the community.
An animal's first day with us is the best day of their life because it's the day that life changes for them. 100 years later, the reality is we're still needed here. We look back over 100 years and we're so proud of what we've been able to do. It's not like a stopping point for us, it's the beginning. What we want most is a world where animals are valued. They're valued by the community, they're valued by families. All we've done for 100 years is try to make the world a better place. I think that that's our commitment for the next 100 years and beyond.